Insert the inner recoil spring into the outer recoil spring. Repeat the same procedure for the other side. Pick up a guide rod and note one end is rimmed. While the other end is slotted. Insert the slotted end first. Insert the second guide rod. Insert both spring assemblies onto the guide rods. Compress one of the recoil springs all the way down until the slotted end of the guide rod protrudes. Grab a retaining clip and mount it into the slot. Using a pair of pliers, snap the retaining clip in place. Slowly release all the tension on the spring. Repeat the same procedure for the other spring. This concludes the reassembly of the recoil spring assembly. Take the hammer spring guide rod and insert it into the hammer and line up the holes. Insert the pin. Place a piece of tape covering both ends of the pin in order to keep it from sliding out. Grab the trigger adjusting bracket and sear spring. Place the spring on the bracket arm and rock it into place. It should look like a person sitting up. Now grab the mechanism housing and place the bracket and sear spring inside. It should look like sitting a pilot into a cockpit. Use a punch to line up the holes. Insert the sear spring retaining pin. Ensure the pin is flush on both sides. Insert the sear into the mechanism housing. Depress the adjusting bracket and advance the sear all the way back. Depress the sear and align the two holes. Insert the sear pivot bushing. Make sure it's flush on both sides. Mount the hammer housing onto the mechanism housing. Insert the trigger assembly. Carefully remove the tape. Use a punch to line up the holes. Insert the hammer pivot bushing. Line up the bushing flat to the edge of the hammer housing. For this next step, you'll need a tube-shaped tool where the inside diameter is just big enough to allow the hammer spring to fit inside. An acid brush works well. Place the hammer spring bracket over the hammer spring. Ensure the hammer spring bracket is resting on the rails. Using your special tool, push the hammer spring bracket up into its notch. Mount the securing plate onto the mechanism housing. Line up the two holes. Drive in the securing plate retaining pin. Ensure the retaining pin is flush on both sides. This concludes the reassembly of the adjustable hammer. Insert the magazine catch into the frame. Insert the spring onto the magazine release pin. Apply lithium grease to the spring. Hammer the pin down until it snaps into place. Place the spring onto the barrel lock pin. Apply lithium grease to the spring. Insert the barrel lock pin into the frame. Insert the barrel lock into the frame. Rest the barrel lock into the barrel lock pin notch. Ensure the barrel lock is flush on the left side of the frame. Before you install the trigger assembly, you must know how it works with the slide catch. The trigger spring performs two functions. It provides upward pressure on the trigger bar, and it also locks in the slide catch. Notice when the hammer bar is bent back into its operating position, the spring will rest in the notch on the slide catch. This is locking it in place. The spring should not be located behind the slide catch, as shown here. Covering the spring with an acid brush helps tremendously in the installation process. It helps keep the spring on the correct side of the slide catch. Start by inserting the acid brush in through the frame from the magazine well. Insert the trigger spring into the acid brush. Push the trigger through the trigger well. Maintain positive upward pressure on the acid brush throughout this process. Press and hold the hammer bar in the forwardmost position. Use tape to hold the hammer bar in place. Line up the slide catch holes. Insert the slide catch. Ensure the slide catch is flush up against the frame. This end of the slide catch should be in the magazine well. Take note that the slide catch return spring has an L-shaped end. Insert the L-shaped end into the frame. Rotate the spring clockwise until it is parallel to the slide catch. Slowly rotate the slide catch counterclockwise until the return spring pops into its recess. Slowly lift the slide catch outward and press up while maintaining contact with the frame. You can now remove the acid brush. The slide catch is locked into place. Remove the tape. Apply lithium grease to the spring. Hook the sear onto the trigger bar. Line up the upper and lower hammer retaining pin holes. Insert the upper retaining pin. Ensure the retaining pin is flush on both sides. Insert the lower retaining pin. Ensure the pin is flush on both sides. Position the grips on the right side first. While holding the grip against the frame, push the grip forward until it is secured to the frame. Repeat the same procedure for the left side. This concludes the frame population. Apply lubricating oil to the extractor recess, the polymer spring, and the extractor. Place the polymer spring in the bolt with the wide base placed against the bolt. When installing the extractor, ensure the polymer spring fits into the spring cup. Depress the extractor to line up the holes. Insert the extractor retaining pin. Ensure the pin is flush. Apply lithium grease to the ejector spring. Start the ejector retaining pin, but do not seat the pin all the way through. Insert the ejector with the flat side of the ejector facing the spring and the notch facing towards the retaining pin channel. Press the bolt face against the table to compress the ejector and insert a dental pick from the other side of the retaining pin channel to capture the ejector. Hammer the retaining pin the rest of the way through. Insert the left safety on the left side of the slide. Ensure the notch is facing downward. Install a safety spring on the left safety. There should be a small gap right here. Install the left safety switch. Ensure the safety rotates with the safety switch. Install the safety screw. When installing the right safety, ensure the right safety flat lines up with the left safety flat. Install your safety spring on the safety switch, the same as the other side, and ensure there's a gap. Install the right safety screw. Insert the bolt into the slide. Push the bolt to the rear and rotate it so that the bolt recess lines up with the guide pin hole. Without rotating the bolt, push the bolt forward to make room for the bolt stabilizer pin. Make sure the bolt cutout on the stabilizer guide pin mates with the bolt during the installation. Install the bolt stabilizer pin over its spring, ensuring the flat end is facing to the rear of the slide. Push the bolt stabilizer pin back until it clears the locking lugs, then rotate the bolt until the bolt stabilizer pin is held in place by the locking lugs. Maintain rearward pressure on the bolt as it is now under spring tension. Install the solid flat end of the bolt guide pin first. Rotate the bolt guide pin until it is aligned with the frame channel in the slide. Install the spring on the firing pin. Rotate the safety switch up. While viewing the firing pin from the rear, rotate it until it appears like a mushroom. Insert the firing pin. When installing the firing pin stop, ensure the rounded end is facing towards the top of the slide and the slotted end is facing towards the front of the slide. Push in the firing pin and slide the firing pin stop down as far as it will go. The firing pin should protrude from the stop hole. Install the gas piston and rotate it until there is a wide opening, as shown here. Install the recoil spring lug into the hole you created with the gas piston. Press the springs down on the other end to make room for the frame. Rotate the barrel lock to the unlocked position. insert the frame on the slide guide rails, and slide it all the way forward until it just clears the recoil springs. Guide the recoil springs into their recess holes as you gently pull the slide to the rear. The barrel lug cutouts on the slide and the frame should now be aligned. Guide the lug through the cutouts until the barrel rests on the slide. While holding the barrel against the slide, rotate the barrel lock to the locked position.